Quédate, ahí está. Guarda la clave entrenando, me voy, me sos parte de la gente, a las puertas y esperamos a generar el pesado, a mi rey. Sobre la nueva revista, me recoge el secreto. El campeón de los Ella, por el U.S. Open, con el San Mercedes Championship Final Tournament, next between France and England. We would like to thank you for coming. Please remember that in football there is no place for racism. Kindly note that smoking in the stadium is prohibited. Thank you. We hope that you will enjoy the game and that the team produced memorable performance in accordance with the spirit of respect and fair play. We spoke teams the best of luck. Prantsusmaa peatreener on tänaseks kohtumiseks valinud järgmise koosseisu. The head coach of France has chosen the following lineup. Number 16, number 16, Lou Marchal. Number 4, number 4, Marie Moulot. Number 5, number 5, Vassan Sangare. Number 6, number 6, Lou Altan. Number 7, number 7, Naoria Traore. Number 10, number 10, Kailin Meidi. Number 12, number 12, Merline Ventale. Number 13, number 13, Carmela Pesiani. Number 16, number 17, Adidia Traore. Number 19, number 19, Paul Pizet. Number 20, number 20, Vendrina Lucinda Pilombi. Ja vahetuses, and the substitutes are number 1, number 1, Alisa Fernandez. Number 2, number 2, Celeste Croix. Number 4, number 3, Tairine Croix. Number 8, number 8, Melinda Mingi. Number 9, number 9, Liana Joseph. Number 11, number 11, Marcel Epa Epa. Number 11, number 14, Elisa Rambeau. Number 15, number 15, Kilian Kelabi. Ja number 18, Julie Svero. Ja peatreener, head coach, Peggy Brost. Inglismaa koondise peatreener on tänaseks kohtumiseks valinud järgmise koosseisu. Number 13, number 13, Heidi Cox. Number 2, number 2, Ria Poos. Number 3, number 3, Mary Ward. Number 5, number 5, Fiki Wright. Number 8, number 8, Alexa Potter. Number 10, number 10, Lola Brown. Number 11, number 11, Eva Baker. Number 12, number 10, Lily Round. Number 14, number 14, Polly Geary. Number 15, number 15, Lucy Newell. Ja number 18, number 18, Erika Parkinson. Ja vahetuses, and the substitutes are number 1, number 1, Sophia Ball. Number 4, number 4, Leila Harder. Number 6, number 6, Sarah Shaw. Number 7, number 7, Rhea Dennis. Number 9, number 9, Michelle Ackermann. Number 16, number 16, Sophie Harwood. Number 19, number 19, Vera Jones. Number 20, Isabella Fischer. The peatreener, head coach, Mo Marley. Tänast kohtumist teenindavad nagu peakohtunik Ilka Vekkeli Soomest, abikohtunikud Laura Cordani San Marinost ja Diana Fernandez Uruguayst. Neljas kohtunik on Anahi Fernandez Uruguayst ja tänase mängu delegaat on Oodi Saarinen Soomest. The officials for today's match are the referee of the match, Ilka Vekkeli from Finland. She will be assisted by Laura Cordani from San Marino and Diana Fernandez from Uruguay. And the fourth official is Anahi Fernandez from Uruguay. The U.S. Spain delegate at this match is Oli Saarinen from Finland. Thank you. Tervitame väljakule Prantsusmaa Inglismaa koondisi. Please welcome the teams of France and England.
Hello everyone, welcome to Voro in Hungary for this top of the table clash between France and England in Group B. Both have won two, both have qualified to progress to the knockout stages, but who will top the group? Well, you know, possibly enjoy the better draw. We shall soon find out. Beautiful day here. Can ask for better temperature. 17 degrees, virtually no clouds in the sky as these two rivals face up here in Group B. Be fascinating to see how they come out of this. A lot of changes to the lineups, both coaches knowing that they are through. Both coaches, I guess, wanting to give some time to the fringe players as well. We'll go through the different changes. So we have had the national anthems. Our referee, by the way, is from Finland, but we do have some Uruguayan officials getting some experience at this game. Let's just pause. The anthems are next.
Lugupeetud pealtvaatajad, palume tõusta Inglismaa hümniks. Please rise if you're able for the national anthem of England. Please remain standing for the national anthem of France.
Done. About to get down to business then. France against England to decide who takes top spot in this second group, Group B. Both with wins, France with the more handsome win, I think it's fair to say. And France, like England, makes six changes. Both goalkeepers have been changed. So Martial comes in for Alicia Fernandez, the PSG keeper. Two Traorés up front, Neolia and Kadida. They'll lead the line, but keep an eye out for Malin Mendy, who scored against Poland. The number 10 has also scored five goals in qualification. As we mentioned, Minka Vekeli of Finland is our official in charge, and we do have a couple of officials from Uruguay. Not obviously within the European group of officials. but coming to gain experience as part of a collaborative UEFA and CONMEBOL initiative. I wish them a good game. Well, the French team are very confident going into this game. I think it's fair to say they have cruised past Sweden, cruised past Poland. Joseph with two goals. She is on the bench. We'll see how they go. Sanger, Olympic Lyonnaise. Potter with the armband for England as well. Chelsea player needs with some authority her team. Lovely compact little stadium this in the southeast of Hungary, and England have enjoyed their stay here as well. Six changes for them, and the top scorer Michelle Agyeman is rested. She scored 4-2 per game. She will perhaps come on later looking after her. She's had a heavy workload, so Brown, Round and Baker up front. Potter in the middle of midfield, and Cox coming in, the Chelsea keeper, in place of Sophia Port of Leicester. So two pretty strong benches for the two teams. Provost and Marley, the two coaches, of course, interesting to hear what they had to say. Provost saying England, big team, physically strong with a lot of speed and direct play. It'll be interesting to see how they play without Agyeman. A big physical presence up front. Ruby Ray Tucker also absent in that warm-up against Sweden. Six points apiece. England's goal difference is inferior at 3. Underway then in this Group B match with two teams that have qualified. England in the white, France in the blue. Just be interesting to see how players who haven't had a lot of game time will go. I know that Mo Marley said everybody has a part to play. Talking about the demands of that Sweden game. 3-1 they prevailed. In fact, they scored all the goals because Reid gave Sweden an own goal. Ooh, a missed kick was from Reid. And here come France with an early opportunity. It's a good save. Cox had to get down. Danger early on. It was Khadija Traoré coming through. Captain Mendy playing her through. Just couldn't quite get the angle, but early warning for England. Bizet with the ball on the throw. Easily taken by Cox. I just want to cool and calm things down. Getting her chance, the Chelsea keeper. Ward. That's Bose on the far side. Little look at her options for Deering. You could hear the shouts of man on, and France have the ball in a dangerous position. Malmendi up against Potter, who does well. Stayed in. Brown, who was impressive in that opening game against Poland. 2-1, of course. Remember, Ward sent off after 35 minutes. The penalty that resulted was saved. And they hung on. An important win, as it turned out. just as a blessings of a very strong squad. France runners up three times. But you have to go back to 2012 for the last time they were in a final. Here they come again. And Khaled gets the ball back again. Here's Graziani up against Bowes. Gets past her as well. Options here. Dealt with just by Ward. Cox was beaten. Parkinson looking to come forward and does so with some elan. Baker. Control the ball. First touch from Marshall. One from Parkinson. Now Bowes has got forward. Lovely turn by Baker. What options do England have here? Far post, nothing. It was a nice ball in. But Brown had at the house on the near post. Marley reigns for England. It's supposed to be that way, but England's coach couldn't make it for personal reasons, so she stepped into the breach. Owens with the throw. Baker comes to get, but couldn't control. Pieces, Brown, Potter, the touch. Now Reed, dealt with nicely by Deering, looks for the long ball. It's a little bit of a ask, isn't it? And that will be a goal kick. Brown looking to fill in that role so wonderfully. Done by Agmian. Four goals so far in the two games. Brown has been a very good provider of ammunition for the English. Marmendi. Get the ball back in. A little bit of time to line it up, but up against the back of Newell. Positioned herself well. Nicely done by Sanger. Bizet goes past one. Sets Khadija Traore on her way. It's nicely intercepted by Ward. Parkinson coming to help out from midfield. Passing the ball around nicely. The French looking very good indeed. Armendi. Zini with the ball in, it's a dangerous one. It could have gone anywhere, and somehow the keeper did enough with Naolia Traore just bearing down inside the 6-yard box. And it bounced kindly for England, but they're still under pressure. Brown. Clattered in the end by Lashimba Bilombi. See it coming, couldn't she? PSG player. It's a little bit late to the party. Ward for England, tries the long ball. much about where that went. Dead round. Now Potter. Rangy run down that far side, and not a bad ball. Tough to put on that far side, and so far hasn't got much change out of Mulo. To retie her shoelaces quickly. Don't quite have the physical presence they do, England up front, when Aguiman is on the ball. Talked about whether they change their game plan. Seems a very good target. Woman. Nice little touch from Traore. Just kept going, but will be pulled back. Another player from PSG. Scored a couple of goals in qualifying. Scored against Poland early on in this tournament. Reed. That's a nice pass to Brown. Again, they look to go long. Keeper should have this one. Martial comes out. Plays in the senior women's PSG team. We're second in the women's league. Last time out, here's Potter. Simba Belomba holds her up. And that's a good challenge. And it's a bit of work to do for Reed. In fact, Cox comes. Does very well commanding her area. Asiani. France in the first 10 minutes was the better of the opportunities, the most of the pressure, I guess it's fair to say. Ball has gone out. Right under the nose of our assistant referee on this near side. Sweden also underway. We'll keep you up to date with the battle to stay off the bottom of the table. 0-0 at the moment, as it is here. Otan Mulo Ziani just looking to squeeze it inside. Simba Bilombi just about controlled it. Here's Traore. No way through. Potter playing with a captain armband in her hand at the moment. It keeps falling off. Good control. Far side for the French. Ball inside is not the best. Most of England's play coming down that far side. It's offside for Baker. Scored the third against Sweden. Any other player but Aguiman to score for England, the Leicester winger. Nicely done by Potter. Parkinson, there's a few white shirts forward here. Brown, no foul, just eased off the ball. She'll look to get back against Ben Khalid. No chance to do so. It's nicely done by the US Orleans player. Just 16 years of age. Seen some very good performances from 15-year-olds in this competition as well. Very good tackle from Bizet. Sends off Malmende for France. England have to be a little bit stronger in the challenge. Strong from Bowes. England coach saying we need to win the ball back, and that is something that England just need to do. Keep possession, win the ball, keep possession. At the moment, they don't have it. Traore. Graziani with the ball in. Oh, it wasn't far away, was it, from the top corner? Cox backpedaling. Cross or shot? Well, if it had gone in, I'm sure she would have said it was a shot. She's just 15, won't be 16 until August. Another one of that PSG cabal of players. Reid will just let that one run out. 0-0 here, 0-0 Poland, Sweden. These two teams, England and France, guaranteed a place. The semis, Spain are also through after a strong show in Group A. Switzerland, Germany, a little later on. That's a terrible touch from Potter. Now then, Ben Khalid, Graziani. Little tussle. Ward wins that one. Don't think there was any suggestion. A foul, Parkinson. Again, just got to be a bit more precise with their passing, England. Neolia, Troy almost closing that one down. I was just saying Switzerland, Germany later on this afternoon. That is a decider as to who will go through. Switzerland have to win. Two more combinations for Germany. That's then. This is now 0-0. I don't think there was much in that. They're always going to go down and give it a go. Can't blame Drury for that. Here's Brown. Pass forward is not a good one. To Round. Not much through the left channel for England at the moment. Brown, and she played match against Poland with Aguilan, was very creative, the provider of opportunities, but a bit subdued so far in this match. Moulin with a throw. Dealt with well by Bowes. Right by Newell, not very far though. Malmendi, well, they've moved it nicely. This is Traore. Takes a deflection, a little back heel from the captain, Mendy, looking for a handball, definitely not interested. Just tried the back heel, tried something different. See if they could surprise and open up the English defence. Neolia, Traore with the ball in, up against Reid. I think it would have been a harsh decision. No goals so far. If you've just joined us, good to have your company here in Voro, where the sun is shining. But we've not had a shower of goals just yet. Did that go out? Yes, it did. England are doing the majority of the defending here. We'll look to improve their retention of the ball. To improve their perhaps passing in the last third as well. Bowes, nice little touch, was just tapped on the ankles. Finnish referee has been on the spot. Kept it in. Ward looking to get the next ball as well. And she'll get the throw. Sanger not happy. Lyon player. So just being given a ticking off about kicking the ball away. I think she's going to get a card. Got an early bit of cramp, or is it an injury to Baker? Ward. There's Baker. Eased off the ball. No foul. Nicely won back by Parkinson, who's in the centre. Should be a goal kick. Just bounced off of Parkinson. Last player. Very good tackle. Lesios is her club, a player playing abroad. Great experience. Fairly tight affair. England's just starting to make a little bit more progress in the French half. Montan will have to deal with that. Brown's on her heels and just puts it out for a French throw. We've had some pretty good weather here in Hungary. A little bit of rain midweek, but certainly blessed. Clear skies. Estonians being great hosts, looking forward to the final. 26th of May, the Kula Stadium in Tallinn. It's a wonderful stadium as well. What an experience for some players. You wonder whether it'll be the French. They've looked very good. Spain also extraordinarily strong. England is certainly be there, hoping they can be part of the story as well. They're certainly through the semi-finals. We'll see how it goes. Spain and either Switzerland or Germany await them. These two teams. Sanger, tall defender, isn't she? That's their keeper, and calmly done to find Mule. Ciani. A challenge. Deering. Noel Mendy with a bit of space. All of a sudden, there wasn't. It was nicely closed down by Ward. Potter. Brown. England combining better here. Ball is for Parkinson to chase. And, for Bizet to deal with. Not many chances. France had one early on in this match, but mostly a midfield battle. Half of this first half gone. England coming a little bit more back into it. No difference between these two teams. 3-0 against Sweden and Poland for France. 2-1 against Poland for England, 3-1 against Sweden. England, four-time semi-finalist. France, three-time semi-finalist. They'll want to go a little better, won't they? At this championships here in Estonia. Is a little quiet in the last 20 minutes up front. Seven. Neolia. 17 is Khadija. Here she is. Talks with a clearance. Parkinson with a bit of work to do. Rees. And Potter. Going on a run, finding a bit of space. She might keep going. That's a lovely pass. Got it past Graziani, very nicely indeed. And Bose looks like she has been hurt in that challenge. Rulo, the fullback, left back for France. She's a French under 17 international, but has been playing PSG for quite some time and is a Paris resident, so he'll be very settled there, I'm sure. And looking very good in defence at the moment for France. Ward. Get completely past Mar Mendy. Oh, nicely done by Traore, but England still have it. Looking to go down the line with Parkinson. Zagare's come across. Ball is in, oh, it's past the outstretched foot of Brown. And Traore will come and chase, and the keeper is out of position. Here's Mar Mendy. Backpedaling is Cox. Mar Mendy still going. It's a good save. The follow-up is over the top from Traore. Mar Mendy just kept going, warmed the palms of Cox in the England goal. And Khadija Traore will be disappointed. All started with a very poor clearance from the keeper. Backpedaling madly, did very well to get back into a decent position. Pushed it right in front of the French striker. Khadija Traore could only hoik it over the top. Perhaps could have taken a touch. Paris FC striker. Those that have come in, these two have made changes, they want to make their mark. France dominating the attempts, quite comprehensively, 5-0. 20 minutes to go in this first half. England huffed and puffed. They've missed Michel Aguiman, I think it's fair to say. Which has a yellow card, of course, as well from the first match. So just wanted to be a bit careful. Not suspended either. It's Brown. Brand. Bose. Potter wants it in the middle, but it's a little bit of keep ball on that far side. Cox, that's a better pass this time. Be a bit careful here, Reed. Mendy was lurking. Good header. Zagare dominated. It's a particular challenge. England, we're pleased not to have conceded, but I think the coaching team will be a little bit concerned about the lack of something up front, causing too many problems for the French. All in from Baker wasn't the best. Zagare. Making a nuisance of herself. She will run and run, that's for sure. If she has the ball, the player's in good position, she can find her striking partners quite easily. Good to see a decent crowd come to watch these two in action. Estonians come out to support the tournament. and to support their team, of course. Taking the lead against Sweden. This other Group B match. Brzezinska with the goal there on 19 minutes. Nothing here though. In Voru, the Voru Sportkeskus Stadion. The more Bijou complexes used. But, a fair sprinkling of bodies come out to enjoy the sunshine. On the stands behind our camera positions is Brown. Mostly done by Bowes, but there's always seems to be an extra blue shirt when they need it. Certainly France looking the better of the two teams. Potter. Drury. Fowler. But that's indicative of what the French are doing. Close down really quickly, and they are physical enough. Potter, again, a misplaced pass from England. I think it's the English who have suffered most by the wholesale changes to the team for this match that will not have an effect. Bearing on who will go through. We know that these two teams will go through. It's coming together, I think both okay. Troy, the French player, Naelia Troyoli. Some big goals in qualification. Looking for some goals here as well. Mar Mendy looking for a blue shirt to pass to. That's a better bit of tackling back by England, but still unable to clear the danger. Here's Traore again. The ball is a simple one. It's a very important interception from Reid. Again, Reid with the ball. It's not been cleared. Away is the call. Ward will oblige. England having to hold on a little bit there. Again, not a clear-cut chance. These two teams, not really. He was just tapped the ball in from a couple of yards after a wonderful move. They are a little bit laboured in front of goal. England really have not had any chances at the other end. And Martial, I'll make sure it's tidied up nicely. Tart. This is Graziani. Looking on Bowes, and she's got a bit of pace, hasn't she? And Bowes will just settle for the throw. Past the half-hour mark. Still no goals here. That was the opportunity. What an important block it was. Oh, Valmendi couldn't get past Bowes. Stepped past one elegantly. France just starting to turn the screw here. Nice first touch from Traore. Khaled comes into the box, wants it. This is Graziani. Again, Bowes equal to the challenge. Corner to defend though. Defense. It's a very good delivery, and Cox comes and punches. Did very well, was very organised there. She's going to have to backpedal here, but the ball sails over the bar. No danger there. Oh, Mandy, the captain, has been impressive, hasn't she? The Lyon captain of the under-17s. Been on the bench for the Lyon senior team. Not quite made it onto the pitch them yet. Performance here will suggest it's only a matter of time. Parkinson chasing. Good chasing down by England. Brown, an unequal contest that one, but she keeps the ball. Potter. England having to backpedal though. Good pressure from the French team. Back into their own half they go. Reed back to Cox, but they keep possession. Fruitful. There's Potter. Now they're getting some shirts forward. Ward on the overlap. Baker is waiting at the far post. Didn't get there. Safety first though from Sungeren. England have their first corner of this match. Immediately Potter's up. Not sure where the there's the armband falling down yet again. Newell is up. Watch this near post. Baker to take it. Brown gets up. Is it kept in by Deering? I don't think it was. Well, Brown, pretty slight, but she managed to get ahead on the ball. Just went over the line before Deering could get a boot to it. It was actually Newell who got the header. Ball through, looking for Traore. Cox reads the ball well and sends it back into the French half. 10 minutes to go in this first half. Not a game that has been peppered with clear-cut chances, but it has been advantage France throughout. Wonderfully done, great skill. And then the final pass, after all that hard work, not the best from Ben Callad. Ward will come fetch for England. Wonder whether they will bring Acumen on in the second half just to see if she can steal a goal. Steal a victory for France. Still Poland 1, Sweden 0 in the other match in Group B. The battle not to be bottom in that particular contest. Mendy spray it wide, looking for Graziani. Boa's header was not very good indeed. You can hear the bench saying, no corner, no corner. Whatever happens, don't make it a corner. Ball in from Bizet. Caught just about by Ward. Now Brown. Long ball looking for Baker. Waved by Oltan. Again, scrappy in midfield. But again, it is France who come away with it. Traore wants options. Decides to go all the way back. Bizet. Sanger. England now trying to do their own closing down. Baker unable to get hold of the ball. Mendy coming through. That's a big ask for Graziani. Just 15 years of age. Graziani. Made her way to the under-17s lineup. He's played in the under-16s recently. He was on the bench in some of the under-17 qualifiers, but jumps like everybody else who's been brought in this match to make a difference. Make your coaches and the scouts who are keeping an eye on these players, just let them take notice of you. Oh, mistake from Bowes. Graziani couldn't find anybody but Brown for England. And the foul from Round is gratefully received. Just trying to come around the side, but it was really from the back. Referee well placed. Will there be a goal before half time? Don't have one yet. Show too much of the ball there. Did Reed. Ward. Still being massively high tempo this match, has it? Both these sides trying each other out. With six changes, players getting used to each other on the each other's sides. Possession football from France. Now the chance to spread it to Graziani. Good first touch, but Bowes read that really well. Deering. Down the line it goes for Brown. With Ben Khaled in attendance. Look at that. That's the way to spend your Saturday. Shoes off. In the long grass. Not a care in the world. And watching the football, of course. Long ball looking for Traore. Now Elia Traore. Potter twisting and turning, looking for options. A little bit bobbly, the pitch in places, so just got to be a bit careful with their touch. And the passing as well. Into the last five, 0-0 here. Referee took a while, but Potter gets the foul. Just eased off it by Kadena Troy. Now Parkinson for England. Just about got the pass away, Deering. Khalid was bearing down. England, this is better. Anyone in the centre? No, but they'll get the corner. Good work from Parkinson, switching flanks. England have another corner. Nice pass from Bowes. No real communication. Safety first for Otan, there's no one behind. So once again, taking up station by the keeper, Martial. To have her wits about her. Taking it short, trying to change the angle, and it's an England header. I think it was Reed who got to it, could direct it. Mendy, who has been impressive running the midfield. Turn of speed on her. She's still going. Skips past one. Into Traore, and the keeper had to come. Coxy very well. Aulia Traore. It's a wonderful run, but goodness to me, didn't Mar Mendy do the work, and very nearly through the legs of Cox. Just got down. Got something on it. Mendy it is, and we'll take this. Off the head of Otan, couldn't control it. England can breathe again. Ward. She's going to have to hurry because Khadija Traore is on her case. Cox. So far, a clean sheet for her. Deering. Just about got the ball through to Ward, who's on a run down this near side. And she's thinking about the shot as well. Oh, what a goal! What a goal for Ward! Round the length of the pitch, thought she'd have a go. And Marshall, who's had virtually nothing to do, could do nothing about that. England, against the run of play, are ahead. A minute left. Oh, plenty for the thoughts of the French coaches. Mind there. What a goal. She just kept going. No one closed her down for the first time, I think. And Marshall may be a little bit disappointed. I think it moved. It dipped and moved. And that's whatever happens for Mary Ward, the Bristol City fullback. That's a better memory than being sent off against Poland, that's for sure. Fourth minute for Ward. England, I think, second best in this first half, but somehow we've come out on top. Cox had to hurry up there, took her time. Parkinson. Can't imagine there'd be much time to be added on. None at all. And well, England somehow have come out of the first half ahead, thanks to Mary Ward. Couldn't quite believe it when it went in. I think she ran and ran, cut inside, top corner. Thank you very much. No wonder she's happy. And France, well, we'll be scratching their heads and wondering how they're not ahead. But they aren't. Half-time here, France 0, England 1.
This is the final match in Võru, the semi-finals of the European Women's Under 17 Championship Final Tournament, which is played on 23rd May in Tallinn.
Welcome back to Voru. We're going to have a couple of changes from the French team after dominating the game really in the first half and going down to a wonderful individual goal by Ward. Mary Ward. Managing to make some space and find the top corner. So it is Melinda Mendy who's going to come on. I think it's Graziani who's made way. I did see Chancel Effa also being readied at half time. We'll confirm that once we are underway. Second half then of this Group B game. England on the break scoring just before half time. And they've rung the changes. France at half time decided something had to change. And it is Khadija Traoré who's come off up front. And Mendy is on. And as we mentioned, Effa also on. So two changes at half time. Make a change. But the second half unfolds. Early intervention from Mendy. This is the other substitute. Effa. They'll be linking up on the left hand side for France. Effa, interesting actually. Born in Le Havre. Been at the club in Le Havre since she was 8 years old. So very much a hometown product for Le Havre. So made some late appearances as a substitute for the senior team. Right. A little bit hot on the challenge from Ben Khaled. England topping the group at the moment. France will be second if it finishes like this. With Poland third, they're two up against Sweden and they are into the second half as well. The goal scorer sent off in the first match for being the last person, well, fouling the last person. England managed to miss the penalty subsequently, but a long time England had to hold on from the 35th minute in that game, so she will be delighted to be noticed for the right reasons. Here's Newell. Well, England to capitalise. Close down, Bulo. On the round. Ben Khaled, finding Sanger. Bizet. They do look comfortable on the ball, don't they, the French. Cox, who has kept her team in the lead, well, enabled them to get the lead because she made some really good saves, a couple of good saves in that first half before Ward struck. Newell, awesome. Lovely little touch, it's just run out by Bowes. Very quickly by that final ball again. Great loops over everybody and Newell just sees it out. Rose will take it for England. Oh, nicely done by Van Khaled. Good tackle, had to be from Deering. Now the substitute, effort. Combining well with Mendy. And the shot from Van Khaled is screwed wide. Oh, it might have taken a touch, actually. I think the referee's decided it is a goal kick. But England give it away a little too easily. It's a little bit scrappy at the moment between these two teams. Misplaced passes abounding. It would appear, though, the good news is Potter has sorted out the captain's armband and it's sticking to her arm. That young lad is still up in that field of wildflowers on the road. Mum's in a comfy seat a little way away. Got a fair amount of fans in the stand here as well. The Voro Sportis Kusa Stadion here in Estonia, Voru. Four venues, a couple in Tallinn, one in Tartu, and this one in Voru. One nil to England. France coming forward again with Ben Khalad. Skips past Potter. We'll have a go, and the keeper, Cox, had to be alert to the danger. It didn't have a lot of power in the end. It's also placed right in a comfortable space for the keeper, but they're here again. This is Malmendi. Surely now, off the line. And over the top, it was Bowes with the save. Effort. And the ball from a couple of yards out. You surely thought it was going in. Great work from the skipper again. Tried to pass it in. And in the end, somehow, between Parkinson and Bowes, they kept it out. Nice touch coming off Effort. Could have gone anywhere. Poland 3-0 up against Sweden in the other Group B match. England having a charmed life in their goal at the moment. Again, here comes France. She's very fast, as effort. Chantal effort. 16-year-old scored qualifying. And has looked a threat already since she's come on. Corner kick. England under pressure. Acquainted. Decent ball in, away by Potter. Now Baker on the break. Looking for options. Holds up nicely. That's a good foot in from Ben Khaled. There were options on that far side. Very much looks like Poland will be third place in the group. Cruising at the moment against Sweden. This is a tighter affair. England having to hold on at the moment after that goal just before the break. France looking very strong in the tackle. Mal Mendy, I've been hugely impressed with her. What a powerhouse, and that's a great pass. Rouleau, two in the centre. She thought of glory, went for the top corner. Head to head. At the moment, it's Aubin France with two wins. The two meetings beforehand. That's Lucimba Bilombi who's down. The French are carrying on with Ben Calad. Cut out by Bowes. Brown will not get there in time. And Lucimba Bilombi is still down. And now the referee will come back and check. PSG, Paris-born player, just got a little knock. Might be the Achilles, which are awfully painful. Never played for the national team before this tournament. Lucimba Bilombi. She's had a good run out here. Mali getting some instructions across. Bowes getting back into position. England have held on in the second half. They haven't really posed much of a threat to themselves. Just thinking, quick thinking from Mendy. Nips in, takes the ball. Always a danger, will have a go herself, and it bounces off the shins of Newell. Good to see Lucimba Bilombi is okay. It's great to see Mal Mendy at work, isn't it? Well, it wasn't the shins, was it? It was the back, the calves of Newell as she turned her back. Corner for France, they'll get another one. Far post delivery is a good one. Sanger tried her luck. There was a wall of white shirts in front of her. Mal Mendy in by Parkinson, a good challenge. A good challenge as well, which leaves Baker with a bit of time, a bit of space. Brown looks for the return, perhaps coming infield might have been a better option, and France have numbers here. Here's Mendy. Oh, it's an awful first touch, and Bowes does well to hang on. A little clip of the heels. And Brown and England can breathe a little easier. Oh, just a little flare of speed. End to end, it's not been an end to end kind of match, but these two teams just for a moment seemed like they were going to go toe to toe. 4-0 Poland against Sweden in the other Group B match. Both these games heading towards the hour mark. Nice first touch from Parkinson. Wonderfully read by Bizet. Mendy, oh, sets Traore away. Effa is in the center, looking for the penalty. Referee out, the assistant not so interested in any shape or form. She's got a bit of pace, hasn't she? And it was an important challenge from Ward. Mary Ward, who scored at the other end. And she's been in the wars, Lucimba Bilombi, hasn't she? At the other end, a bit further up the field. Elia Traore. Looks like they've got two cans of magic spray. They have. And England set to make some changes. Ismael Fischer, the Arsenal striker, coming on. Looks like Baker's going to make way. He's trying to clarify. Yes, it is. It's Fischer for Baker. I think it's the only change they're bringing on. No. Dennis is also going to come on. Billy Rhodes is the one who will make way. Fielder is on. And Harbert comes on for the captain, Potter. And, takes the Arsenal player, takes the armband as well. Three changes then, gets some fresh legs on at the hour mark. Won't make much of a difference. Here is Harbart. Ball over the top. It's going to be dealt with surely by Sanger. Control of it though, Parkinson down the line again. It's Ward who's made it into the corner. England hanging on to that one goal on the 44th minute from Mary Ward. Bristol City fullback, a lovely run, wonderful finish. That's what I feel they've been robbed. They've played well, but always a chance someone's going to pick your pocket. Here's Mendy, gets past one, good positioning from Bowes though, knew she was going to cut back in. Perhaps a chance for Fischer to get involved, not this time. First touch from Mendy, oh, the ball bobbled horribly. Altao. Here's Sanger. Bizet. Brown is trying to nip that ball back, doing the chasing down for England. France. Always dangerous when they come forward. There's a little bit of space here for Mulo. Good ball in. Important clearance from Newell. Now Dennis. Quite finding Fischer for the second time. She's frustrated. They also says the referee, looked a heavy challenge from Deering. Referee decided there was no foul on Traore. Bizet coming forward, trying to show some pace. Oh, nicely done by Ward, who's having a wonderful game at the moment. A goal, the difference between these two teams. Still plenty of time for that to change. You're finding Bowes. Little turn was a decent one from Dennis, and she's taken the ball off the toes of Altan. Is there anyone central? Oh, it wasn't the best ball. And it's just gone over the top. Oh, she could have placed it. Fischer really was impressive. Dennis made the run, made the challenge. Fischer was in space. to come back. And you're always leaning back, aren't you, when you're trying to retrieve that. Didn't have a lot of time and just scooped it over the bar. But very impressive from both those players, both the substitutes combining. England showing a little bit of pace and bite. Remember their top scorer, Michelle Aguiman, on the bench. I don't think she's going to feature. They will keep her nice and rested, make sure that yellow card that she got in the first game doesn't make too much of a difference. Mendy is down. England are on the attack. Brown looking for Dennis. And she has brought a bit of authority, control, possession to England, and they look a much better side for it. Mendy just about getting up. Oh, that's a lovely ball. A chance for Fisher, who is offside. Harbert possibly better to have a go from the edge of the box. Well, the three substitutes have been busy for England, haven't they? That was the challenge. It wasn't a foul, I almost said foul on Mendy. She's running it off. Melinda Mendy still looking a little uncomfortable there, isn't she? Mar Mendy never seems to be uncomfortable on the ball. Mary Ward finding Brown. Slight but strong anyway. It's Fisher. Oh dear. Not the first time offside. Possibly Dennis might have been the better option. It's Bizet, now Mar Mendy. Double teamed. And she'll be hauled up for handball. And she is not impressed. Well, she held the ball, thinks she had the free kick. Referee thought otherwise. She's keen, our Finnish referee, to keep things moving on. Newell, she's been very impressive at the back for England. That's a lovely pass as well. Time for Autumn, but did very well. Reed played the ball forward. England have it again. Fisher. They look for the throw. I don't think she's going to get it. Well, England's substitutions have been effective. They've still got a bit more spark about them. Certainly saw against Poland, they were very good up front. Had to hold on in the end, of course, just down to 10 players. Harbert bringing it wide. Here's Dennis. Brown's making the run. She'll look to go herself, perhaps. Captain has it. Harbert with the armband. The same role as Potter, who had to pass the armband to her when she came off. Ward. Brown couldn't control it. Dennis, and it's cleared in the end by Ben Khalid. England having the best spell of the match from their point of view. Brown will not get there though. Playing it much nicer now. France perhaps tiring a little bit. They have been very impressive, but forever, of course, not been on for that long as she is. Has looked speedy. Somehow France keep possession from that scuffed goal kick. Here is Effa. Bit of space for the shot, and the captain glass over. Mendy to the left foot. Keeper not bothered. Mendy and Mel Mendy. Now on the pitch, of course, for France. Brown for England. It's a nice ball through to Dennis, who's got past the keeper as well, and blasted over. What a challenge that was from Mulo. France at sixes and sevens. Dennis is a real handful. Skips past the challenge. Couldn't quite keep it on, and in the end, Mulo came back and made a very good recovery. Chance for England to double their lead. Dylan Job has come on. Shimba Volimbi has come off. She was struggling a little bit with injury, I think. Got a knock or two. Set Etienne player on. England, though, looking to get that second goal. Further forward now, but they've got to be careful on the break. Here's Effa. Now Mendy, first touch for the new substitute. Three changes so far per team. I think fitness levels are going up as well. Haven't had cramp so far. Mendy. Cut out, read well by Deering. England, I was about to save, look to try and cut out the poor passing. Long ball this time. That's one for Fisher to chase. Not had much luck up front since she's come on. Putting a five up against Sweden. Another Group B match. Effa comes inside. England playing themselves out of trouble. Grzeszko has two. No hat-trick as of yet for Poland. Not a goal fest here, but it's an enthralling encounter. Who knows, you never know. Perhaps these two might be the finalists. They know how to make it through to be runners-up. Effa inside the box. The flag has gone up for offside. France, three times runners-up. England, four times semi-finalists. Senior women, of course, European champions. That win over Germany at Wembley, but this is a different matter. Oh, that's a fabulous ball through, looking for Job. Quite make it stick. Enterprise and endeavour. No foul on Fisher. Another change about to be made. She's put a very good shift in, hasn't she? Sophie Harwood will come on for the hard-working Maria Bowles. Southampton player is on. Looking for the corner, England, not getting it. On the charge on that far side. Thank you. because interception from Brown wasn't the greatest kick you'll ever see from Marshall. It's a little bit better, finds Shaw. But physical presence from Dennis. Nips the ball off for her. Wonderful little bit of skill. She can hold off challenges, can't she? But not that one. That was a decent one from Ben Khalid. Taking away now from Otan. And a very good interception. Here's a chance. Oh, blasted wide from Dennis. Excellent tackle from Parkinson. Did ever so well. Under a bit of pressure. Hit it with the left. Couldn't find the target. England much better in the second half. Again, poor kick. Marshall seems to be under a bit of pressure. Fisher is running and running, can't get the better of Ben Khalid. And now here come France. Traore inside, in space. Oh, an easy tapping. Effort. Right place, right time. But the hard work done by Traore. And France 11. Well worked. And England have done a lot of work at the other end, but they were caught short here. Harwood not getting the right side of a player. Wonderful run from Traore. So, goal back for France. And they will stay top of the table if it stays like this. Ironic, wasn't it? In the first half, France pushing. England score. And, England had a 10, 15 minute spell when they were pushing. France got the other end and scored. I don't think it's a travesty of justice. They've certainly deserved a goal. Both these teams, of course, going through. Poland, by the way, 6-0 up against Sweden now. Down. Armendi is pushing through. France looking to get this goal. Not like that, they won't. This will make the last 10 minutes or so interesting. That is Cramp. She has been on and spearheading the attack. Chance for everybody else to get some fluids on board. Straight away, felt that calf muscle. Remember, we've had a lot of substitutions, so we'll have quite a bit of time to be added on. This match against Poland, each half had 8 minutes. There was sendings off and penalties and goals. And yeah, a lot of substitutions. O'Malley still smiling despite her team conceding the equaliser. She knows she has a few more secret weapons, well, not so secret, but weapons up her sleeve when it comes to the knockout phases. Three days time, semi-final day. 26th of May is the final in the Kula Stadium in Tallinn. Referee has not brandished a yellow so far, trying to keep this game moving along. She's had a bit of a talking to Mulot. Is there another goal in this game? Just over 10 minutes to find out, plus injury time. Oh, there's space for effort on this near side. Nicely done by Harwood, a substitute doing her defensive duties. More work for the England defence.
Thank you.
2 minutes to go. A few English fans spread amongst the locals. We keep their fingers crossed here. It's a great delivery that was easily dealt with. It's hard with the header. Now here's Traore, the provider for the French goal. Not great from Harwood. El Mendy unable to get the ball away, but here's a chance. Oh, looked like for a moment it was going to curl into the top corner for Ben Khaled. England now with Parkinson. No foul. El Mendy on the ball now. Shadowed by Reed. England clearing the danger. Brown with a good first touch. Drury, not such a subtle touch. Hugely impressed with Brown. Drury is going to make way. Not surprised, she has run her socks off. Melissa Rambo will come on. Yeah, 16-year-old from Montpellier coming on. Did get a goal in qualification. So can she get one here? We shall see. Parkinson unable to get to the ball. Twisting and turning, Sanguier. Did very well. Now Ben Khaled through the middle, cut out well by Reed. Now then, Fisher. Oh, just wouldn't run. Brown trying to just get the little tip over the defence. But chasing shadows, Deering trying to get to terms with FRF. Mal Mendy. Good movement from the French. Harwood got something onto it and manages to come away. Good strength though. Chancel for effort. Goal scorer for France on 76 minutes. Wars with a wonderful solo effort just at the end of the first half. That's how it stands. 1-1. And Fisher made an impact when they came on as substitutes, but last 5 minutes or so, a little bit anonymous. Parkinson not able to distract Ben Khaled. Bit of space to run here. Nice ball through. No one at the far post. Tired legs, gaps just starting to appear in this match. Rambo, a substitute with her first meaningful touch. Parkinson with a foul. Pizé looking to the referee, a little bit of help there. At the moment. nicely down by Rambeau. Difficult ball to control. Kowinska, by the way, has got a hat-trick now for Poland. No one in danger of doing that here. Just over five plus injury time to go in this engrossing match. Fischer, tap on the ankles, but gets the ball away to Newell. Pass to Cox, pass wasn't the best or the easiest. Reed trying to get the ball away, running into good closing down from the French Marmende, all over the pitch, isn't she? Leading by example, the French coach, and I know Peggy Prevost will appreciate that. You feel then maybe it's not been a game full of chances, but is there going to be another sting in the tail? Parkinson, that's one for Fischer to chase. Doesn't get the throw. Touch of cramp, yeah, Deering. Another busy midfielder for England. He's feeling it, the Man United player. Man United player in the squad. Oh, just a little bit of overextension will do it. Newell. But that is off Shinzo, a French player, so it will be a England throw. Harwood looking for options. Pushing the back from Ben Khaled, referee well placed. Towards the end of this match, England took the lead. France have fought back. The show will chase that down to the end. No chance in the end. Michelle. Take a time. Well, it's been very impressive, but England have shown they're not unbeatable, that's for sure. Spain will be confident going into these semi-finals. 3 days' time. Nicely done. Dennis looking to put Brown through. Switzerland have been a surprise package as well. If they get through, you never know. Nice done by Deering. Seems to have stretched off that cramp. Harbert down the line. Ward. Cut out by Bizet. Flag will go up against Marmendi. Space for Brown. Ooh. Still not a bad ball. Parkinson will launch it up. It's a header from Bizet, and that'll be a corner for England. Bizet has hurt herself as she came down. Can get forward, did so wonderfully in the first half. That's a Wonderful goal. Keeper will be a little disappointed perhaps not to have got something on there, but that was a great goal. This, more of a tap in. The run, the mazy run coming from Neolia Traore. It was very good throughout her appearance. England with the corner. Not cleared by France. Parkinson. Ball in. Is a good one. Danger on the edge of the box. It won't fall for an England player. Dennis going through the box. Brown. Oh my word, that wasn't far away. Parkinson in the melee as well. Yeah, it was Parkinson, in fact, turned. Well, could have gone anywhere. Good header from Harbert. Substitute taking the armband and stepping into that sort of central midfield role generally. 5 minutes of time to be added on. Plenty of time for something to happen, and it might be effort that happens. Ah, Mendy, she's in on goal! Oh, sprays it wide. Acute angle. But even so, Parkinson, here's Brown, wants it down the line, Parkinson. Brown wants to get it onto her left foot. That's a lovely little header from Fisher. And they're quite happily settled for the corner kick. And this is at the other end. Through two tackles, tiring defence. And it was a difficult angle. Brown with the ball. There's a good header away, and somehow the French scramble it, only as far as Ward. She'll have a little dink from a distance. It wasn't far away. Keeper, I think, had it covered. Ward looking for a second. England finishing strong. Yeah, I think the keeper would have been fine. Not a bad option though. She's very central, wasn't she? Let's put your lasers through it, see if you can get a bit of power. But England have had the better of the second half, despite conceding in the second half. France, by much the better team, I think, in the first half. If it is a draw, well, it may not be, because here comes Dennis, marshalled by Buzet. Got to be careful, got inside the box. Anywhere will do for France. Cox, oh, has to be careful as well. Being closed down quickly. Fisher. Parkinson, oh, just couldn't get the ball earlier on. Showing some skill and some stamina. Over the head of Dennis. Well, that would have been a wonderfully worked goal had it gone in, but it was just a little too high for the substitute. Cox will launch it. That's a good header. But still England come there, finishing the stronger of the two at the moment. Ball in, little flick on, oh, and the chance fell to Fisher. Dennis involved as well. France very nearly giving away the penalty as well. Just about got the shot away. Joel was doing her job, putting pressure on the England striker. England at the death, almost taking all 3 points. Well, Mende has a bit of pace here and might just do it. Oh, it's just gone wide. What a scramble that was. Everyone held their breath. No one quite knew where it was going to end up. Well, she has got great levels of fitness and actually great levels of skill to keep that ball under control as it bobbled around and somehow it stayed out. Chances both ends. Entertaining match. It's really coming to its own, come to life in the last 10, 15 minutes, really. France are looking to break the English hearts. I know there's nothing at stake yet. They're both coming through the groups, but they're both, as you can see, giving it their all. They want to be top of the group. Is there a bit more time? No, there isn't. Excellent match. It means that France will stay top of the group on goal difference. England thought they may be able to squeak it. Mali's team were excellent in the closing stages. They had a wonderful individual goal from Mary Ward to put them in at the break, one up, but effort, really rewarded France's hard efforts with that equaliser on 76 minutes. Both these teams through to the semi-finals, both these teams will be contenders. Full time here, France 1, England 1.
May 25 wishes a home and hope to see you soon.